Sintra asterisco 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 produced by Vasco Salgado Mário Beirão Sintra edição da Renascença Portuguesa Porto 1912 Sintra do autor O Último Lusíada, no prelo, Mário Beirão Sintra edição da Renascença Portuguesa Porto 1912 A Teixeira de Pacoeso Pena, altar de nuvens sobre a serra, Passo de Sambras Reais, feito em granito e séculos de azul olhando a terra das janelas que hoje vão infinito. Ó voo das florestas que se esfolham, tuntas de céus, fragancio. Ó tardas sambras roxas da distância. Ruínas noite donde as águias olham. Ó cedros esmanchando as ramarias, afofando penumbras. Crepúsculos longínquos de arcarias. Água que, ao pôr do sol, és murmura e deslumbras, que deslumbras meus olhos, meus ouvidos, e, incerta de gemidos, vis esculpindo a diáfanos lavores as pedras onde o sol desmaia e verte cores. Ó paisagem do céu! Sintra! Visão suprema! Arquitetura dos acordes de um poema. Em ti as mãos do vento em fúria batalharão. O Dinho e a lenda para Eilam te perpetuarão. Ó graça que desceste à terra por encanto, granitos que, ao luar, sois brancos alabastros, ramos verdes, à noite, onde estremecem astros, meu canto vem de vós, é para vós meu canto. Fraguedos, serrania, do alto de vós olhando, tolhidos de invernia, alados de neblinas. Nos lanjas acenaes, noctivagus, em bando, franjas, espuma vaga de cortinas, aéreas e navedas, farrapos onde a noite esconde as madrugadas. Ó figuras dum drama subterrâneo, gélidas do pavor das sambras que repassam. Fragas, espectros vãos, que a um rasgo momentâneo, o vento esculpe e os raios despedaçam. E ao longe o mar é um canto de epopeia memorando naufragios. Profundo ferve, anseia, lívido estagna, e sonha, e para no caminho. Eis que numa revolta, amargo de presagios, lavra de espuma e som visões em desalinho, rasga o pano da noite e, monstro de éguas, uiva, e tomba doido a rir, sobre os érias, exausto. A areia escalda ao sol. Ígnea de sede ruiva, mina-se de água e azul, absorve o mar num hausto. Ó Sintra, rente ao céu, o mar te afaga, floresces em murmúrio, em hálitos de vaga. De ti eu dominei, varei os horizontes, estou cansado já, fui Júpiter na terra. Nas tuas fontes, onde um crepúsculo era e o ar é de abandono, que eu fosse o musgo em sombra verdecendo, a voz de longe e outono, baixinho fenecendo. Fosse a humildade. Os úmidos recantos onde a sombra se esquece, incerta de saudade, e a chuva se eie em prantos. Fosse o tronco musgoso, enverrugado, onde lembrança eterna, um coração se vê de setas trespassado. Fosse a elegia do ar quando o ar inverna, rumores de água, queixas, mansa, como rezando, por que me deixas? Como que a sombra diz no seu silêncio frio a fonte de esquecida memorando, lucilante de lágrimas a fio? Ah, pudesse eu viver pela espessura dos basques rumorosos, as horas em que a sombra as coisas transfigura. Ser o outono, o crepúsculo, a harmonia das aves cuja voz é um hálito de luz de poentes que morrem de saudosos. Vestir os tracos nus, chorar melancolia. À tarde, quando a luz penumbras vem rezando, a forma é aparição, alegrimas de azul as almas orvalhando, a cor é emanação. Tudo se transfigura, a paisagens, cinere ous pela altura. Eu deixo de existir para mais dentro em mim viver, sentir. É a hora transcendente em que o passado surge evocador do escuro, e, sôfrego, o presente desalava névoa do futuro. Ó pena ao alto erguida, recortada na sombra asa de águia perdida, nas rochas esfarpando-se. Nuvem numa outra nuvem evolando-se. Ó Sintra, ao poente, a fumos de viuvez, subindo num adeus, chimérica de longe a terra já não vês, é uma ânsia de infinito a que te abrasa, ó verde forma de asa com frêmitos de céus. Ó Sintra és já distancia na comunhão dos astros. Teus granitos transformam-se, alabastros, de brancos a rezar. Ideal sonância. É, eu que vivi em ti, riso contigo, eu, o incerto, misérrimo mendigo, trago nos olhos tristes pedrarias, astros radiando pálidos fulgores, desmaios de harmonias, no concerto mais íntimo das cores. E a noite escuta, empalidece, um murmúrio de vozes voaça numa prece, flébio, o ar magoando, idílios suspirando, duma estrela que nasce ao pôr do sol o canto chora, lágrimas sem fim. A alma de um rouxinol sonha com Bernardin. E desfez-se, apagou-se em ondas de saudade o olor mais doce. Súbito, heroico de saudades, um canto acorda, funde o bronze das edades. Ó canto pela noite, em prantos marulhado, memória em cujo olor há mortas primaveras, pelos astros, o espaço cadenciado, ungido pela benção das esferas, falas da minha raça, dos profetas invectivando o mar, de moiros pela areia, cujas setas eram menos mortíferas que o olhar. Ó ritmo das oitavas nas veias do meu sangue a tumultuar. Ó lira de Camões, acordes de ondas bravas. É, bronzea a voz sucumbe, os céus ficam arfando, reboando, echoando. Mas a candura, a graça do sorriso, de quem vive a morrer, e tem no olhar de mágoa o paraíso, e Deus no coração sem o saber, desfolham-se num hálito de outono pelos céus, pelas almas de abandono. Ó moreno cantor a ouvir de bruços, das góticas ogivas merencoreias, musgosas de saudade, ecos de uma outra idade, vozes de viola zoando moribundas, morrendo gemebundas, crepúsculo de som, penumbra de memórias. Ó Lusíada absorto na chimera do Eilamo. Infante é tudo morto, de que serve esperar? Falas de longe, a morte diz a vida a sua grande, eterna despedida. Em ti, meu pálido anto, há mortos a falar. Ó moribunda voz em lágrimas de canto. E eis-me perdido e só, como um ceguinho, tactei os céus de estáctica harmonia, e vejo Deus em mim a ungir-me de carinho, e sou onda de luz em melodia. Morri para viver Eilam da morte, meu negro olhar agora é azul celeste, ouço na minha lira o meu transporte, Senhor. Bendita a morte que me deste. Ó floresta! Ó granitos revestidos de auroras e crepúsculos e lenda, que o som da minha lira a voz acenda. Vossa escultura de íntima harmonia seja acordes em ecos desferidos, eternidade, azul, melancholia. Quero inclinar a fronte, Quero dormir ouvindo de além mundo meu carme gemebundo rasgando nuvens, céus, aladamente, e, baixinho, humaníssimo, contente, umedecendo ressequida fonte. E eis-me esculpindo formas de florestas, eis-me gravando a som um tronco esquálido, abrindo nas prisões esguias frestas, por onde o luar se escoa muito pálido. Eis-me gravado a som, eis-me esculpindo ó Sintra o teu perfume pelo outono. Eis-me sagrado e lindo, rasgando a luz à noite do meu sono. E vivo a eternidade no meu canto. Atônito de mim, revolvo mundos, sou mágico de encanto, erro pelos abismos mais profundos, e trago auroras rútilas nos olhos e harmonizo de paz os horizontes. Sou melodia úmida do mar rezada nos escórios. É, ao vir do outono, incerto de distância, saudoso olor memora a minha infância, vou ausente de mim por mim a andar. Tudo o que eu fui acorda. É água viva. Sintra, vagueio em ti. Nas tuas fontes minha saudade em lágrimas deriva, e o outono é o meu fantasma a recordar. Ansede. Outubro de 1912 impresso em novembro de 1912 na tipografia Costa Carregal, Treve. Passos Manuel, 27 Porto. Biblioteca da Renascença Portuguesa Águia Revista Mensal, Vol. I, 1 a 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 e 11. A Vida Portuguesa Quinzenário Ennius 1 e 2. A Evocação da Vida Augusto Casimiro. Regresso ao Paraíso Teixeira de Pascoaes. Esta história é para os anjos Jaime Cortesão. O Espírito Lusitano ou o Saudosismo Teixeira de Pascoaes. A Sinfonia da Tarde Jaime Cortesão. O Criacionismo Leonardo Coimbra. A Educação dos Povos Punin Salars Ribera Y. Rovira. Romarias Antônio Correia de Oliveira. A Primeira Nau Augusto Casimiro. No Prelo, O Doido e a Morte Teixeira de Pascoaes. Da Quem e Deilim da Morte, Contos, Jaime Cortesão. Camilo Inédito, Notações de Vila Moura. Asterisco, 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 End of the Project Gutenberg Ebook Sintra, asterisco, 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 Update de Editions Will Replace the Previous One the Old Editions Will Be Renamed. Creating the Works from Print Editions Not Protected by U.S. Copyright Law minus that no one owns United States Copyright in these works. So the Foundation, and you, can copy and distribute it in the United States without permission and without paying copyright royalties. Special rules, set forth in the general terms of use part of this license, apply to copying and distributing Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Works to protect the Project Gutenberg Trademark Concept and Trademark. Project Gutenberg is a registered trademark, and may not be used if you charge for an e-book, except by following the terms of the trademark license, including paying royalties for use of the Project Gutenberg trademark. If you do not charge anything for copies of this e-book, complying with the trademark license is very easy. You may use this e-book for nearly any purpose such as creation of derivative works, reports, performances and research. Project Gutenberg ebooks may be modified and printed and given away you may do practically anything in the United States with ebooks not protected by US copyright law. Redistribution is subject to the trademark license, especially commercial redistribution. Start, full license the full project Gutenberg license please read this before you distribute or use its work to protect the project Gutenberg trademark mission of promoting the free distribution of electronic works, by use or distributing this work, or any other work associated in any way with the phrase project Gutenberg. You agree to comply with all the terms of the full Project Gutenberg trademark license available with this file or online at www.gutenberg.org/license. Section 1. General Terms of Use and Redistributing Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Works 1. By reading or use any part of this Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Work, you indicate that you have read, understand, agree to and accept all the terms of this license and intellectual property. Trademark/Copyright Agreement. If you do not agree to abide by all the terms of this agreement, you must cease use and return or destroy all copies of Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Works in your possession. If you pay the fee for obtaining a copy of your access to a Project Gutenberg trademark electronic work and you do not agree to be bound by the terms of this agreement, you may obtain a refund from the person or entity to whom you paid the fee as set forth in paragraph 1.E8. 1.B Project Gutenberg is a registered trademark. It may only be used on or associated in any way with an electronic work by people who agree to be bound by the terms of this agreement. There are a few fees that you can do with most Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works even without complying with the full terms of this agreement. See paragraph 1.C below. There are a lot of fees you can do with Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works if you follow the terms of this agreement and help preserve free future access to Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works. See paragraph 1.E below. 1c. The Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation, the Foundation or PGLAF, owns a compilation copyright in the collection of Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works. Nearly all the individual works in the collection are in the public domain in the United States. If an individual work is unprotected by copyright law in the United States and you are located in the United States, we do not claim a right to prevent you from copying, distributing, performing, displaying or creating derivative works based on the work as long as all references to Project Gutenberg are removed. Of course, we hope that you will support the Project Gutenberg trademark mission of promoting free access to electronic works by freely sharing Project Gutenberg trademark works in compliance with the terms of this agreement for keep the Project Gutenberg trademark name associated with the work. You can easily comply with the terms of this agreement by keep this work in the same format with a tactful project Gutenberg trademark license when you share it without charge with others. 1.d. The copyright laws of the place where you are located also govern what you can do with this work. Copyright laws in most countries are in a constant state of change. If you are outside the United States, check the laws of your country in addition to the terms of this agreement before downloading, copying, displaying, performing, distributing or creating derivative works based on this work or any other project Gutenberg trademark work. The foundation makes no representations concerning the copyright status of any work in any country other than the United States. 1.e unless you have removed all references to Project Gutenberg, 1.e1. The following sentence, with active links to, or other immediate access to, the full Project Gutenberg trademark license must appear permanently whenever any copy of a Project Gutenberg trademark work, anywhere com which the phrase Project Gutenberg appears, or with which the phrase Project Gutenberg is associated, is accessed. Displayed, performed, viewed, copied or distributed, these e-books for the use of anyone anywhere in the United States and most other parts of the world at no cost and with almost no restrictions whatsoever. You may copy it, give it away or reuse it under the terms of the Project Gutenberg license included with this e-book or online at www.gutenberg.org. If you are not located in the United States, you will have to check the laws of the country where you are located before using this e-book. 1.e2. If a individual Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works derived from texts not protected by U.S. copyright law, does not contain a notice indicating that it is posted with permission of the copyright holder, the work can be copied and distributed to anyone in the United States without paying any fees or charges. If you are redistributing or providing access to a work with the phrase Project Gutenberg associated with or appearing on the work, you must comply either with the requirements of paragraphs 1.e1 through 1.e7 or obtain permission for the use of the work and the Project Gutenberg trademark as set forth in paragraphs 1.e8 or 1.e9. 1.e3. If a individual Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works posted with the permission of the copyright holder, your use and distribution must comply with both paragraphs 1.e1 through 1.e7 and any additional terms imposed by the copyright holder. Additional terms will be linked to the Project Gutenberg trademark license for all works posted with the permission of the copyright holder found at the beginning of this work. 1.e4. Do not unlink or detach or remove the full Project Gutenberg trademark license terms from this work. Or any files containing a part of this work or any other work associated with Project Gutenberg trademark. 1.e5. Do not copy, display, perform, distribute or redistribute this electronic work, or any part of this electronic work, without permanently displaying the sentence set forth in paragraph 1.E um effective links or immediate access to the full terms of the Project Gutenberg Trademark License. 1.E6. You may convert to and distribute this work in any binary, compressed, marked up, non-proprietary or proprietary form, including any word processing or hypertext form however, if you provide access to or distribute copies of a Project Gutenberg trademark work in a format other than plain vanilla ASCII or other format used in the official version posted on the official Project Gutenberg trademark website, www.gutenberg.org fecha parênteses you must, at no additional cost, for expense to the user, provide a copy, a means of exporting a copy, or a means of obtaining a copy upon request, of the work in its original plain vanilla ASCII or other form any alternate format must include the full Project Gutenberg trademark license as specified in paragraph 1.E1. 1.E7. Do not charge a fee for access to, viewing, displaying, performing, copying or distributing any Project Gutenberg trademark works unless you comply with paragraph 1.E8 or 1.E9. 1.E8. You may charge a reasonable fee for copies of your providing access to or distributing Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works provided that, item you pay a royalty fee of 20% of the gross profits you derive from the use of Project Gutenberg trademark works calculated using the method you already use to calculate your applicable taxes. The fees owed to the owner of the Project Gutenberg trademark. But he has agreed to donate royalties under this paragraph to the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation. Royalty payments must be paid within 60 days following each date on which you prepare, or are legally required to prepare, your periodic tax returns. Royalty payments should be clearly marked as such and sent to the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation at the address specified in Section 4, Information about Donations to the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation. Item you provide a full refund of any money paid by a user who notifies you in writing, or by e-mail, within 30 days of receipt that he does not agree to the terms of the full Project Gutenberg trademark license. You must require such a user to return or destroy all copies of the works possessed in a physical media and discontinue all use of and all access to other copies of Project Gutenberg trademark works. Item you provide, in accordance with paragraph 1.F3, a full refund of any money paid for a work or a replacement copy, if a defect in the electronic work is discovered and reported to you within 90 days of receipt of the work. Item you comply with all other terms of this agreement for free distribution of Project Gutenberg trademark works. 1.E9. If you wish to charge a fee or distribute a Project Gutenberg trademark electronic work or group of works on different terms than are set forth in this agreement, You must obtain permission in writing from the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation, the manager of the Project Gutenberg Trademark Trademark. Contact the Foundation as set forth in Section 3 below. 1.F1.F1 Project Gutenberg Volunteers and Employees Expand Considerably Effort to Identify, do Copyright Research on, Transcribe and Proofread Works Not Protected by US Copyright Law in Creating the Project Gutenberg Trademark Collection. Despite these efforts, Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Works, and the media on which they may be stored, may contain defects such as, but not limited to, incomplete, inaccurate or corrupt data, transcription errors, a copyright or other intellectual property infringement, a defective or damaged disk or other medium, a computer virus, or computer codes that damage or cannot be read by your equipment. 1.F2 Limited Warranty, Disclaimer of Damages, except for the right of replacement or refund described in paragraph 1.F3, the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation, the owner of the Project Gutenberg Trademark Trademark, and any other party distributing a Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Work under this agreement, disclaim all liability to you for damages, costs and expenses, including legal fees. You agree that you have no remedies for negligence, strict liability, breach of warranty or breach of contract except as provided in paragraph 1.F3. You agree that the foundation, the trademark owner, and any distributor under this agreement will not be liable to you for actual, direct, indirect, consequential, punitive or incidental damages even if you give notice of the possibility of such damage. 1.F3 Limited right of replacement or refund, if you discover a defect in this electronic work within 90 days of receiving it, you can receive a refund of the money, if any. You paid for it by sending a written explanation to the person you received the work from. If you received the work on a physical medium, you must return the medium with your written explanation. The person or entity that provided you with the defective work may elect to provide a replacement copy in lieu of a refund. If you received the work electronically, the person or entity providing it to you may choose to give you a second opportunity to receive the work electronically in lieu of a refund. If the second copy is also defective, you may demand a refund in writing without further opportunities to fix the problem. 1.F4 Except for the limited right of replacement or refund set forth in paragraph 1.F3, these works provided to you as is, with no other warranties of any kind, express or implied, including but not limited to warranties of merchantability or fitness for any purpose. 1.F5 Some states do not allow disclaimers of certain implied warranties or the exclusion or limitation of certain types of damages. If any disclaimer or limitation set forth in this agreement violates the law of the state applicable to this agreement, The agreement shall be interpreted to make the maximum disclaimer or limitation permitted by the applicable state law. The invalidity or unenforceability of any provision of this agreement shall not void the remaining provisions. 1.F6. Indemnity, you agree to indemnify and hold the foundation, the trademark owner, any agent or employee of the foundation, anyone providing copies of Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works in accordance with this agreement, and any volunteers associated with the production, promotion and distribution of Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works, harmless from all liability, costs and expenses, including legal fees, that arise directly or indirectly from any of the following which would or cost or occur. A. Distribution of this or any Project Gutenberg trademark work. B. Alteration, modification, or additions or deletions to any Project Gutenberg trademark work. And C. Any defect you cause. Section 2. Information about the mission of Project Gutenberg trademark. Project Gutenberg trademark is synonymous with the free distribution of electronic works in formats EW by the widest variety of computers, including obsolete, old, mid-aged and new computers. It exists because of the efforts of hundreds of volunteers and donations from people in all walks of life. Volunteers and financial support to provide volunteers with the assistance they need are critical to reach Project Gutenberg trademark S goals and ensuring that the Project Gutenberg trademark collection will remain freely available for generations to come. Em 2001, the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation was created to provide a secure and permanent future for Project Gutenberg trademark and future generations. To learn more about the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation and how your efforts and donations can help, see sections 3 and 4 and the Foundation Information page at www.gutenberg.org. Section 3. Information about the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation. The Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation is a non-profit 501(c)(3). Educational Corporation organized under the laws of the State of Mississippi and granted tax-exempt status by the Internal Revenue Service. The Foundation's or Federal Tax Identification Number is 64-6221541. Contributions to the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation are tax deductible to the full extent permitted by U.S. federal laws and your state's laws. The Foundation's business office is located at 809 North 1500 West, Salt Lake City, UT 84116. 801596188. E-mail contact links and up-to-date contact information can be found at the Foundation's website and official page at www.gutenberg.org/contact section 4. Information about donations to the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation Project Gutenberg Trademark depends upon and cannot survive without widespread public support and donations to carry outubro its mission of increasing the number of public domain and license to works that can be freely distributed in machine readable form accessible by the widest array of equipment including outdated equipment. Many small donations, $1 to cifrão 5,000, are particularly important to maintaining tax-exempt status with the IRS. The Foundation is committed to complying with the laws regulating charities and charitable donations in all 50 states of the United States. Compliance requirements are not uniform and it takes a considerable effort, much paperwork and many fees to meet and keep up with these requirements. We do not solicit donations in locations where we have not received written confirmation of compliance. The send donations or determine the status of compliance for any particular state visit www.gutenberg.org/donate. While we cannot and do not solicit contributions from states where we have not met the solicitation requirements, we know of no prohibition against accepting unsolicited donations from donors in such states who approach us with offers to donate. International donations are gratefully accepted, but we cannot make any statements concerning tax treatment of donations received from outside the United States. U.S. laws alone swamp our small staff. Please check the Project Gutenberg web pages for current donation methods and addresses. Donations are accepted in a number of other ways including checks, online payments and credit card donations. To donate, please visit www.gutenberg.org/donate. Section 5. General Information about Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Works. Professor Michael S. Hart was the originator of the Project Gutenberg Trademark concept of a library of electronic works that could be freely shared with anyone. For 40 years, reproduced and distributed Project Gutenberg trademark ebooks with only a loose network of volunteer support. Project Gutenberg trademark ebooks are often created from several printed editions, all of which are confirmed as not protected by copyright in the US unless a copyright notice is included. Thus, we do not necessarily keep ebooks in compliance with any particular paper edition. Most people start at our website which has the MyMPG Cert Facility, www.gutenberg.org. This website includes information about Project Gutenberg trademark, including how to make donations to the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation, how to help produce our new ebooks, and how to subscribe to our email newsletter to hear about new ebooks. Mário Beirão Sintra Sintra do autor Mário Beirão Sintra no Prelo, The Full Project Gutenberg License.